Are you recording? Let's do this. What up, YouTube? This your boy Darius. We're about to react to watchmojo.com, the top 10 Michael Jackson song. What's your favorite Michael Jackson song? Like, mine has always been Beat It or Wanna Be Started Something, or even Man in the Mirror. I hope I see at least two of those songs on here. But you know, Michael Jackson, like, he always been one of my favorite artists. Like, no, my favorite artist of all time, ever since I was a little kid. It didn't matter if he was black or white, you know. Like, he was just, you know, like, he was just an incredible artist. Like, Michael Jackson is probably the only artist I love more than Tupac and the Beatles. Those are my top three artists of all time. Like, I remember when I was in communication class, they asked if you were in a, trapping an island somewhere, and you can only choose three artists to take with you in a stranded island. Who will you pick? Me, I pick Michael Jackson, the Beatles, and Tupac. What would be the three artists that you guys would pick? But let's get to with this video. Let's see what's in the top 10 list. I see my brother's favorite song like that.
He was the king of pop.
He was.
The gloved one, or simply MJ.
MJ.
Welcome to WatchMojo.com, and today we're counting down our picks for the top 10 Michael Jackson songs. For this list, we've based our choices on a mix of chart success, song quality, critical acclaim, and popularity. We've also excluded duets, collaborations, covers, and songs with the Jackson 5.
Yeah. I love the Jackson 5 too, but I don't think it's always fair to include him in Michael Jackson's song. Well, I love this song. If you guys have a chance, check out the infamous trailer parody of this song. Michael Jackson loves it.
Treated listeners to an unforgettable medley of pop, rock, and dance. Add a powerful message about race, a rap breakdown, and some heavy metal guitars, and this worldwide chart.
Slash was playing the guitar for this song.
Artist with a Billboard Hot 100 number one in the 70s,
Slash from Guns N' Roses,
and 90s. Its music video also made history.
Tyra Banks.
500 million tuned in for its television premiere. Number 9.
Oh, I love this
way
song.
You make me feel.
It like this little funky
Wait,
blues
this song makes
rhythm.
Me feel is in love. You made me with the high heels on. You made me the Thanks to its funky R&B, blues harmonies, and pop flavors, Bad's third single took us on a rhythmic and romantic journey straight to the top of the Billboard Hot 100.
The way you made me feel. That one time Michael Jackson became a crip.
Its sexy music video had the king of pop flaunting his incomparable dance moves while trying to win over a beautiful woman, which he does, of course.
Michael Jackson disco
eight,
period.
Don't stop till you get enough.
I know I can't sing.
Solo single from his first non-Motown album. Don't stop
One
till you get
is already
enough.
With a cherry curl,
Michael could find success when he took over singing and songwriting duties.
I always say Off the Wall is his first true debut album. Even like I know he released four solo album when he was with Motown, but I feel like Off the Wall, his fifth album, really is his true debut album, because that's when he really break out on his own. Like they say, this is when he had full control over his music, and this is when, you know, like, he was starting to break out on his own instead of being just a part of a Jackson 5. It seemed like those solo albums, it really felt more like he was part of Jackson 5. While here, this is when he was really a solo artist, if that makes sense.
By capitalizing on the disco era, the upbeat chart topper melded pop and funk with an unforgettable melody and won Jackson his first solo Grammy. It also introduced many vocal techniques that would later become his trademarks, including his unmistakable falsetto.
There's rumor that his father had him castrated. I don't know if you guys are aware of castrati, where back in the old days, back especially in Europe, they would have boys castrated so they can still preserve that high voice. I'm not too sure in this case, but with the Jacksons, you just don't know.
Number 7, Rock With You.
I love this song. It's like a smooth disco track. I would say
Jackson
smooth funk, really.
Jackson followed up his first single from Off The Wall with this pop, funk, and R&B-infused track. Thanks to its sensual beat, smooth vocals, and carefully arranged strings and horns, this number one song makes you want to rock with Michael all night. You gotta feel that beat, and we can ride the boogie,
share that beat of love. Rock with you all night.
As one of the biggest and probably last smashes of the disco craze, Rock With You also had us boogieing with its simple, sparkly, but effective music video.
It did. That's how music video was like in the late 70s. Check out Knock On Wood by Anita. What's her name? I forgot.
Number 6, Smooth Criminal.
You know, this is my older brother, Marcus, favorite Michael Jackson song. Shout out to my big bro, Marcus. And to his family. Shout out to my sister-in-law, Farron, Samari, Samaya, and Zeron. You know, shout out to you guys. You know, I love you guys and everything. So I can't wait to get on this trip in a few weeks.
Made Smooth Criminal one of MJ's signature tunes.
It is.
You'll also probably never forget seeing the gloved one break out the anti-gravity lean in the video to this fast-paced Jackson Penn number.
That's it was his shoes. It wasn't a string. That's it was his shoes. Oh, yes. Yes. I love this
number
song.
Number 5, Man in the Mirror.
Gonna make a change.
Though he was most known for his versatile vocals and unrivaled choreography, Jackson also used music to convey powerful themes. So
that was like
the
first of one of those songs. Like he was seeing more of that later down his career, like "Heal the World" and "Cry." I always love when he makes those type of songs. It's like a gospel, pop song.
Grammy nominated tune simultaneously enhanced its pop, R&B.
I know my older
nephew,
Samari, he loved Michael Jackson as much as I do. It's like a funk rock song. This one's supposed to be a deal with Prince, but their ego just got in the way.
And leading a group of street dancers, Michael really showed us who's bad. Martin Scorsese's music video for the title track.
Oh yeah, it was filmed by Martin Scorsese.
Was the perfect accompaniment to the song's dance pop.
The video was actually 17 minutes long and had Wesley Snipes in it. As one of the gang members.
The Jackson could adapt his style to suit the music, but it also allowed him to display his cool moves in the process. The song itself also became a number one smash. Thriller.
It's definitely a funky disco song. Like one of that disco songs.
Whether it's the red leather jacket, those dancing zombies,
it's definitely one of the greatest music videos of all time.
The foulest stenches in the air, the funk of 40,000 years.
You can't help but think of the music video when it comes to this song.
This
while a creepy bass line and some synthesizer gave like Thriller a horror, funky disco feel. Song. It's the song's catchy chorus and funky disco sounds that thrill us most. Oh, the title track was also the best-selling album's seventh Billboard Hot 100 Top 10 single. Number two,
yes.
Beat It. Though he was known
like
more
a hard R&B song,
R&B, disco, and
it had
funk.
Eddie Van Halen at the guitar. Rest in peace, Eddie Van Halen. So beat it.
By mixing heavy guitars, including Eddie Van Halen's driving solo, with rhythm and blues and an unforgettable backbeat, Thriller's third single topped both the pop and R&B charts. The success of the Grammy-winning tune and the popularity of its much-aired music video also helped make Michael an international superstar. Number one.
Billy T was really my brother Marcus' favorite song.
With its unmistakable bass line.
I don't think that's Michael Jackson's best song, to tell you the truth. I don't think that's even the best song on the Thriller album, but it's an amazing song. It's a funk song.
Perfect blend of dance, pop, and R&B cemented Jackson's place in music history, while its video helped popularize it.
The music video had nothing to do with the song. That's good.
MJ further solidified his pop culture presence when he busted out the moonwalk during a television performance celebrating Motown. Do you agree with our list? What's your favorite?
It's not a bad list, you know, per se. Voila.
Be sure to subscribe to watchmojo.com for more entertainment.
It's not a bad list, you know, like, everyone has different opinions, you know. I have my own opinion on what the best Michael Jackson song is. And you guys will hear that on my other channel. What my personal favorite Michael Jackson song of all time is. Thank you guys for watching. What is your personal favorite Michael Jackson song? I want to see in the comment section. But thank you guys for watching. Subscribe to your boy. Peace, love, and rock and roll.